Devastating stories are emerging from those who survived a ferocious fire in Wellington that has killed at least six people, with that toll expected to rise. Authorities have confirmed the 92-room hostel in the city centre was not equipped with a sprinkler system, leaving some with no way out. Dozens of people are injured, including one person who was forced to jump from a third-floor window.
Wellington firefighters have described it as their worst nightmare. Flames shooting from the building, five residents trapped on the roof, and others forced to jump from windows to save themselves.
It was just getting to the stairwell, you know, it was thick as smoke, you know, it was hard to breathe.
Resident Chris only managed to grab his hat before crawling to the fire escape. He says some residents believe the blaze was deliberately lit.
It was on like half an hour before it.
Right, and where was that?
That was in the lounge.
On the third floor.
But our security dude who works there, he managed to put it out. And then after that, it happened again.
The Loafers Lodge in Wellington was at capacity. At least 94 people were sleeping inside when the fire broke out. The building had smoke alarms, but many say they were frequently set off and they initially ignored it. Local building codes didn't require a sprinkler system to be fitted.
Yeah, there was smoke like coming down the stairwell, so I just did a lap around of our floor, knocking on doors, saying, everyone out, this one's real.
And I know that two of my mates have made it out, but the way things are looking for probably four other people I know in there, I don't know.
52 people from the hostel are now being housed in a nearby community centre, where locals have been dropping off spare clothing.
Shock and sadness. There was sort of some relief from families who came in and saw that their loved ones were right.
But so many here still don't know what's happened to their friends and family. The hostel's roof has partially collapsed and contains asbestos, hampering firefighters' efforts to reach some rooms.
It is an absolute tragedy. It is a horrific situation, and in the fullness of time, of course, there'll be a number of investigations about what has happened and why it happened.
I expressed my condolences on behalf of Australia to our friends in New Zealand at this very difficult time and offered any assistance.
But it may revive debate over a controversial Australian policy. Two of the missing are so-called 501s, New Zealand citizens deported from Australia for committing crimes.
And a tragedy like this will really rock the city, and it'll take us some time to come back from this.
The search for answers will be long and painstaking as families here continue to wait and hope.
Well, Taylor joins us live now from the scene in central Wellington. And Taylor, this site is still very dangerous. So how long until police can start examining the scene?
Sandra, while we've just seen in the last few minutes some activity inside the building, we have seen some people in there with torches, but we do understand that police will be in there first thing tomorrow morning to begin examining the scene. Now, what awaits them inside will be particularly grim. They'll start first and foremost with looking for those people who are still unaccounted for. And of course, they'll begin that all-important investigation into what sparked this deadly blaze. Now, we know that this hostel did have a number of long-term residents, and we're told that many of those people were quite elderly and would have faced such challenging conditions trying to escape the flames. They're still unsure exactly how many may not have made it out alive. For those who are confirmed to have died in this tragedy, their conditions and the nature of their injuries means that they haven't yet been able to be formally identified. Sandra, that's only adding to the turmoil for their families as they face a very long night ahead without answers. They're hoping they might get some tomorrow.
Difficult times indeed. All right, Taylor, thank you.